this album right here, as we pull in, this is, I mean, look at this thing. How many songs and what he's done. So with this Hank Williams, Lost Highway, can you tell me a little bit about this album and this song as I turn it up here?
If I had to find one, that would be my favorite Hank Williams song. Would be that. There's many that.
Yeah.
I ask you this. Answer me honestly, Shane. All the stuff that Hank Williams did, name one of them that wasn't great.
Yeah.
They were like the Beatles. Every song perfectly recorded, solos come in just right, it's in the right key, every single one of them. And he recorded about 300 of them. I don't know the exact number. But with that and playing live, he squeezed that into the 29 years of his existence. It's just mind-boggling.
Yeah.
And everything he does, touches, is brilliant. There's not one of them you say, well, this one's not doing too good, or this one, I don't like this one. They'll just start with anything. Even his B list is better than most artists' A list.
Yeah.
He's the man.
Well, 1949, and as he says in here, like a Rolling Stone, you think about that and you think of what he influenced out of his lyrics, out of everything, like a Rolling Stone. That could go to Dylan, that could go to the magazine, that could go to, you know, all of these things.
But, yeah.
You know, when you, it all kind of, to me, it just kind of points back a little bit to Hank.
Well, I say this, and I don't know if it's happening, but I would say there should be rules. There should be rules. Every country band, when they play live, should be by law to play at least one Hank Williams song. Understood?
Yeah.
Every blues act that plays should be playing one Robert Johnson song, or something of a Robert. And every rock and roll band has to play a Chuck Berry song. If you don't do that, you're a punk. I don't want anything to do with you.
Yeah.
How's that sound?
That sounds fantastic. And even with the song, I know Jeff Buckley played this song. There's been numerous people. Willie Nelson's done this. I mean, how many people have done a cover of this?
Well, if you get to a record and you're running out of time, you're running out of space, and you need another cut.
Yeah.
You can't go wrong with Hank Williams. You can't go wrong there if you put an extra one in your album and you want to complete the thing. I don't want to use the word discovered, but I know another word. I was turned on or discovered the artist Hank Williams and Robert Johnson at the same time.
Yeah.
I'd only heard one song by Hank Williams, and I'd never heard any Robert Johnson except for the one the Cream does and the Rolling Stones. So when I heard Hank Williams, and then about a week later I heard Robert Johnson, and I was bouncing back and forth trying to figure out which one was the greater artist. I couldn't choose. I said, these are the two greatest artists I've ever heard. Every one of them is flawless. I mean, I was dumbstruck. I was just sitting there listening to one and listening to the other, and I said, they're still trying to top those two guys, and they never will.
Yeah.
It's never gonna happen.
Yeah.
So there you have it.
Rock legend George Thorogood is making his Grand Ole Opry debut. Don't miss this historic performance by an American music icon on this special live broadcast on Saturday, April 24th at 9 p.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. Central. Opry member Luke Combs and Nico Moon will also perform on this legendary stage with George Thorogood. Go to Opry.com for more info on how to watch and listen from home.